Nephew.
Man, what he do?
Again, I think in this class, we've got five really complete heifers. Again, not one heifer I think really jumps out and hits you, just like our last senior class. I think, again, we'll have this heifer come to the top. I think it's just the most complete heifer. She's got some rib to her. She's probably the most angular of the heifers here. She's probably got the most body mass. Just a really nice female to look at from the profile. And you get behind, and she's maybe not as stout as the second place heifer, but she's just maybe put together a little bit nicer. The heifer in second is the big-bodied, powerful heifer. I'd like to see her clean her up through her front end to get past this first-place heifer. I do like the body of this second heifer. Same goes for the third heifer. She's not quite as nice up through her front end. Maybe doesn't quite have the shape in through her hip that the heifer above her has. A heifer that, when you look at her from the side again, she profiles well. Same goes for the heifer below her. Probably the most striking female in the class. I just don't think she has the top when you get behind her that some of the heifers above her have. A heifer that rounds out the class just doesn't quite have the thickness to her as the females above her, but a strong class of heifer calves here.
All right, thank you, Colton. So leading off in first place in our second split of senior heifer calves, we have entry 571, Red Terron Zaria, 14G from Terron Farms, Forestburg, Alberta, Canada, Hallie Adams. Second place, entry number 2, Red Pyro Red Cap, 941G from Michael Zoller, Pyro Red Angus exhibitor. In third, entry 102, Red Peterson Lassie, 39G, Peterson Livestock, Edgerton, Alberta. Fourth place, entry 14, Red Shiloh Gracious, 24G, Shiloh Cattle Company, Craig Mile, Alberta. And in fifth, 122, Red Honeybrook Hobo's Pursuit from Honeybrook Farms, Melissa Monteith, Enam, Saskatchewan. Well, welcome back to top two from our two splits. From 7A, we have 580 and 38. You just follow Blaine in there, girl. Everything be beautiful. All right, and then the top two from our last class, 571 and 2. And here we go, Judge Hamilton. This will be the four heifers you will choose our two senior heifer calf champions from. Here's our judge with some comments in a senior heifer calf division.
I think we've had two solid splits in this division. We've had quite a variance in the type that we've seen between the two classes. I'll just go and pick the two that I like the most.
And our senior champion heifer calves from our second split, entry 571, Red Terron Zaria, 14G from Hallie Adams at Forestburg. And reserve is first from our first split, entry 580. It's a Forestburg total domination in this division with Red Ridge Classic Lady, 334G, your reserve senior heifer calf champion for Red Ridge Farms, again of Forestburg. Congratulations to all. Well, here's where the fun starts to happen. It is champion female time. All Our Grand Champion female class, sponsored by Royal Rock Angus. That jack will be presented by Gord King, and Reserve Grand Champion moving on farms, and Brooke will handle those duties. So we're going to start with our Junior Heifer Calf Champion, which is on the next page. 619 and 1. Then our intermediate heifers were 399 and 651. Our senior calves we just had, they're 571 and 580. Then our yearlings. Oh, we're still waiting on a calf for two. Here's our champion senior yearling, 143. The reserve is 575, and then our senior champion females, 573 and 41. All right, with that, I think we have a full ring, and class is complete. Folks, how do you like the Red Angus Championship class so far? Folks, before Colton says anything, how about the job he's done so far sorting through these Red Angus? Colton Hamilton.
I think we've got an extremely impressive championship class out here. I think when you start at our youngest heifer and work your way down, down through our senior champion there, I think we've got females that have some body and some mass to them. They've got some rib and some shape, but still femininity to them. Still, they look like females. And I think, you know, if you look at these heifer calves and project them down the line, and if they turn out like what the senior champion is, obviously you can see there's some productivity there. That cow is doing a great job. Both these two cows are. So I think we've got females that, you know, have some power, have the ability to go out and raise bull calves, but still have some femininity and some class to them. I think a really great group of females here. Congratulations to these exhibitors. If you give them a round of applause, and I'll go and pick my two champions.
Grand Champion Red Angus Females, your senior champion. Entry 573. She is Red Tarn Brandy, 127E from Casey Adams at Forestburg, Alberta. Congratulations. She will receive the award from Royal Rock Angus, Gord King presenting. And reserve champion is our cow, You Bet, entry 41, Red Northline, Kea Puddin, 226D from Kelsey Noddard Rawson. We will have a pitcher break. If Kelsey can control her cow, it shouldn't take too long. And I meant that in a nice way. If you need a break, this is the time to do it, folks. The reserve grand champion female presented by Moving On Farms, Brooke King. Gordy's doing it for Royal Rock. We'll be back here as soon as the pitchers are done. And we'll start into the Red Angus Bull Show.
What's the matter with the clothes I'm wearing? Can't you tell that your tie's too wide? Maybe I should buy some old tab collars. Welcome back to the age of jive. Where have you been hiding out lately, honey? You can't dress.